हेलो
Morning, everyone.
गुड मॉर्निंग गुड मॉर्निंग
Yeah, so we'll wait for a few minutes. Let me send the remainder also in the group. I forgot to send it before. I think it's a weekend mode, so not.
Yeah. So if anyone is confirmed yesterday, then we can wait a few more minutes, I think.
Yeah,
I think all the available participants, their mics are mute. So can we switch it on so that at least that time we can make use of them?
Okay. I unmuted.
I think someone's microphone is on.
Yeah. I think.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone.
Hi, Rajesh.
Hello, Sumesh. Yes.
Your virtual background is very apt for the presentation.
Exactly. That is yesterday I was trying different frames and it looks fine.
This one looks the best, yeah.
Thank you. Hi, good morning, Mithun.
Good morning, Sumesh.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. Few videos are not on. I can't see Dr. Siju.
He's right here though.
Yeah, but his audio is off. Mithun's audio is also off.
Yeah. How about Nagraj?
I just put it on.
Yeah.
Hi. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning to all.
Good morning, Sumesh.
Good morning. Good morning, Sumesh. Good morning, all.
Hi, good morning, Kingston. Good morning, Aziz.
Ramadan Mubarak to all.
Yeah, not yet, but tomorrow, right?
Yeah. It's today. Yeah, but in Kerala for you today, yeah?
No.
Bro? Started today.
Yeah.
Normally,
always.
Hi, doctor.
And what did you?
Yeah. It's been a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been very long.
A lot of new faces.
Yeah, I think I see a lot of new people here. I mean, whom I don't know. Maybe not during my episode days.
Yes.
Maybe. What is today is noon time because of Ramadan? Ramadan, you are showing noon time?
No, I just got up because I want to just meet the Ramesh. So I didn't take bath or something. So I am just hiding myself.
Only living in only the office style.
Abdulaziz, I could not complete your session yesterday because late evening what happened is here thunderstorms and it started, so then I had to switch off. The first half I had been there, I was there. After that, it's the last 20-30 minutes I could not be there.
Even I was frequently going out and coming in because of some network issues.
Maybe you was going for some energy drinks.
Sumesh, good morning. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Yes,
Sumesh.
Is it Vinod?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, but I can't see you.
Really?
Yeah, you are.
Okay. Fine.
Yeah, he's off.
It's okay now?
Yeah, now I can.
Background will change at all.
Yes, Rajesh, we are hearing.
Hey,
your
buddy.
What
is that?
Rajesh, your video is not on. People are eager to see you.
Arey, Jesus Christ, that I don't think so. Well, I'm sorry. There
bottom
you go.
Bottom left, there are two icons, no? That the video.
Yeah, okay, I've done it. It's gone. It's done.
Still, it is not on.
No? All right, it's on here.
Stop what is going on?
To me, it's okay.
Anyone else can see him? I think.
No, Rajesh, it's not. We can't see you.
Stop video, mute my audio, pin video. Is it the pin video?
No, it's still mute, I think. You know,
your voice is also mute.
My voice is mute now?
Rajesh, Rajesh, your voice is clear, but your video is still off.
Yeah, but I think video started something. Either you are in dark room or are you using the
bright? I'm not sure that, you know, but could be something else though.
You using mobile or laptop?
No, I'm using my laptop.
Okay, so maybe
probably. You know, my Apple had some fall. Okay. So probably that has messed up my video. I remember that guy telling me.
Okay, yeah. I think we are good to start. Almost 26 participants. So, Sumesh, what do you think? We can start now.
Yeah, up to 25 are there, no? So anyone else is expecting, or then?
See, actually, I just put a reminder. There is no.
Okay, fine. That may be enough, I think.
So. Okay, let's do it.
So, Lebin, you can have an introduction.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. So, as you know, Sumesh was here for a long time, our senior member. And he left Muscat maybe 1 year back. Yeah. So, he has done a lot of wildlife trips. And we wanted to hear from him what is his journey. I mean, how he came and become become a successful wildlife photographer. He started writing some journey articles and all in the books. So let's hear from him. So warm welcome to everyone. And thanks to Sumesh for offering this session. And we have some members like Rajesh Krishnan, our old member. He also joined, and some friends from Salala Photography Club and our members. Welcome everyone. So let's, Sumesh,
over to you. Thank you very much. Good morning, all. So all, I think very few faces are new to me. Other than that, like especially like Rajesh Shetan and all, we had birding together long back, like 2014 and 15. So it's, I'm also a little bit excited to give a session, a talk about my wildlife journey. So good morning, everyone. And I'm really thankful to FSO, because that was the pool where I started my photography journey, and all the guys were still around, and it's, I'm very happy with that. And the advice for our new guys, whoever is there in FSO, make use of that platform, because I think Rajesh Shetan also may be a very right person to speak about that one, because we all started our photography early days with FSO by knowledge sharing, and so it is a great platform anyway. So make use of that resources. All that stepping stones are still available there, like KK, Libin, Baiju, Abdulaziz. You know, I'm not taking any names here, but all these legends are still around. So make use of that resources to develop you to become a photographer or improve your photography. So let me just share my screen at this time. Libin,
yeah.
Are you there?
Yeah.
Can you see this?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So this particular session is not about wildlife photography, or it is not about a story of a wildlife photographer. So more or less, it is going to be like a explaining my journey to become a photographer or wildlife photographer. Means I'm not yet a wildlife photographer, a very successful or very legendary wildlife photographer, but my journey is still continuing. So I'm just explaining about my journey, the way I am started, and the tips and tricks which I learned from mentors and my through my journey from the field, and all these things I'm trying to explain as much as possible from my side. And all these any questions or anything, at any point we can pause and we can have a discussion. So what I'm suggesting,
Vinod, I'll let you manage the questions. You'll be the until KK join, I think.
Okay, yes. Okay. I'll not.
Yeah. So any particular question which is relevant to that particular frame or particular page, then we can pause and we can have a discussion. So at the same time, anything which is not relevant particularly about that particular frame and a general questionnaire sessions, then we can push it back to at the end. Otherwise, it is going to be a lot of discussion in between, and probably we will shift our topic to some other direction.
I think you should put it to the end, Sumesh.
Sorry?
You should put it to the end. That makes sense. Otherwise, you'll have a lot of interruptions coming in, and better to get all the questions together.
Yeah, I'm also preferred to do that. But at the same time, if something is particular about that particular frame, you know, because I'm sharing a lot of pictures in between. So if something related to that picture, then we can have a small discussion and knowledge sharing between us.
That's what, okay, I mean. No props.
Yeah,
let's do.
So let us start. So the Yeah. So the topics which I'm going to cover today is, let me just adjust my screen. Yeah. The topic which I'm going to cover today is, like, first of all, the introduction, which Libin already have done, that one. I'm Sumesh. Basically, by profession, I'm an engineer. I was there in Muscat and Middle East for quite 15 years, long time. And now from last 1 year, I'm taking a job break and I am at home at the moment and enjoying an intermediate retirement life, you can say. So other than that, I'm as good as a normal photographer like you, the way, the journey also the same way. So let us have that discussion. So today I'm going to cover the topic, like the first thing is my learning curve, how I started my photography and what was the initial gears which I used and the way I, top up my gears and this thing, I upgraded the upgrading of my gears and my photography journeys. Second thing, yeah, exactly, the camera bag. I mean, whatever accessories I am used to have in my bag for a wildlife safari. Then I'm going to take you through some of my pictures, which I took from different areas, including Muscat, India, and the other wildlife parks wherever I visited. Then I'm going to explain to you, like, how do I prepare myself for a wildlife safari. So, and there we can explain, we can understand what is the importance of preparation for a wildlife safari before it's actually going to the field. So a lot of things you need to prepare to get to become it as a successful story. Then I'm going to explain something about the wildlife photography places where I am visited, the African countries which I visited, and the different parts in India and all. I'm going to explain that one. Then more or less, we will have a small discussion about do's and don'ts. So whatever learnings I had in my wildlife safari, the tips from our mentors, the guides and all. The do's and don'ts, the risk factors in wildlife photography and to get a better photos, what are the things we need to be prepared ourselves. Then photography, how it can be used for conservation or how we can keep the wildlife, whatever we are seeing today, to keep it for our future generation. What are the things, how we can contribute to that one? So that is some sort of discussion we can have. I'm not very, very authentic person to discuss about conservation, but at the same time, it is one of my wish and I'm going to try, that is in my future mission, it is, maybe some way we all need to be part of conservation also. So we can have a few words about that one. Then, of course, the question and answers, the queries and discussions we can have at the end. See, basically these topics, it is not like a chapter wise. I didn't arrange it like a chapter wise one by one, because, more or less it is going to be a discussion, an interactive session. So, broadly, these are the topics I am going to cover today. That is what I mean to say. Like, in between one topic and other topic may be overlap for the discussion sake or in sharing knowledge point of view. It may overlap. But at the same time, this is the overall topics which we are going to cover today. Are you okay? Any other suggestion we need to add or we need to, find some time for anything else?
I think that's pretty good enough.
Yeah. Okay.
Sumesh, just one suggestion, like we have such today. Along with your photos, if you can just share what all gears you have used or what are the applications used and all, that will help us to understand. That will be a great help.
Yeah. All right. So let's thank you very much. Yeah. Because I think I arranged my pictures in that way only. So we can have, you know, if there is any particular doubt which is not covered in that picture, then we can have a discussion and probably we can, I can share it even in future also. So it's not an issue.
No problem. No problem. Okay. No problem. Thank you. Yeah.
So let us move. Let me start with something technical along with the subject. So I just term it as a result triangle. What does it mean, result triangle? Because why I use this particular term is because we, as a photographer, we all are familiar with exposure triangle, right? So the exposure triangle is pretty much familiar to all of us, and the important factors and the weightage of each factor to get a proper exposure. The same way, I just arranged it the result. The result means, here the result is like, you know, the capture of a shutter release. So that is the result. So that result, that particular result is has got some, you know, inputs to become it as a photo. So this is what I'm trying to explain. So it is also exactly similar to our exposure triangle. So here the major three factors are, one is subject knowledge, second thing is skill set, and third is the quality of your gears. See, this, all these three factors, we individually will explain, but at the same time, I'm just getting you, linking these three things to a frame, you know, to a picture. Especially being, it is, you know, this session is particularly about wildlife photography. The subject knowledge is exactly the most important part. So because unless otherwise, you know, you don't have a, you know, rich background or rich knowledge about that subject, that particular subject, that the behavior of that subject and all, I mean, how it is going to behave at particular time, you will not be able to be safe at the same time, and you will not be able to take a good photo. So the knowledge about that particular subject is key. That is the key of that wildlife photography. Second thing is the skill set. What do you mean by skill set? You know, the skill set is the technical knowledge as well as, you know, basically skill set. Again, we will have a discussion about that one separately, and the quality of gears. I mean to say, the result of an shutter click is a trading of these three points. You know, this is the negotiation between these three factors, and which will give you the exact result as a frame. So you just, this is a frame which we click with our camera. So in this, you know, it is just briefing you how it is interpreting these three factors to a picture. You know, the subject knowledge, you should know that particular subject, the owl, the spotted owl, it is going to give a staring look at you. But at what time it is going to get, you know, you need to observe the behavior of that bird. At one fine moment, it is going to look at you. So you should be prepared for that. But your skill set, in the sense, you know, the camera and the angle, you know, exactly how it is going to look, and there should not be any disturbance to its face. You know, you need to position your camera, and your shutter speed should be according to that particular scenario. That, so everything you need to have that skill to understand. And third thing is the quality of gears. That particular gear should be capable enough to take this picture. Now we will have a discussion about this thing individually. One is, the first one, as I told you, it is subject knowledge. See, subject knowledge starts with, like, first of all, you need to love that subject. As long as it is a wildlife photography, you need to have that love towards subject, rather than, at the same time, photography also, you need to have that passion. But the key thing is loving that subject. So, see, in nature, everything is not rainbows. You know, there are some dirty animals. There are some, look, not very lucrative and not very, you know, what I can say, like, in, for example, like bats, hyena, and all. These are not very charming animals or charming species. But in ecosystem, in our the food chain system, they have definite roles. So we need to respect those that position, and we need to start loving each and every subject and their natural habitat. So you should not tamper with their habitat. So you need to understand that means they have their own habitat and don't disturb that particular habitat. You take your pictures, cherish with that one, carry your moment, but at the same time, the prime stuff is loving of that subject. Second thing is, like, you know, you have to observe the mood, behavior, and activities of the subject for taking a good picture. So this all discussion is about taking a good picture. What are the things you need to consider? Third thing is the feeding habits. You know, how it is feeding, what sort of feeding habits they have. So you need to gather all these information. See, these days you can have all these information from internet or travelogues or the documentaries. So many things are available. So these things we need to develop ourselves. Then gather their breeding, mating, and display habits. Because as long as if you are talking about the birds and all, they have very pleasant, very, you know, beautiful display habits like a peacock and a gray crown heron, crane and all. So these birds has got very beautiful display habits. So to capture those moments, you need to be aware about that their habit, their which season, particular season they are going to demonstrate it, and at what distance you need to keep yourself for a for a comfortable to give a comfortable position to them. So all these things you need to gather. Now, when you are really into any photography, wildlife safari, so that time, these other information like YouTube, website and all this may not be available right in front of you. So the best resource besides you is going to be your guide. So talk to him, make use of his knowledge to get more, different and, behavior and, attitude frames. So your guide is going to be the very reliable next resource, sitting next to you. So make use of that. And the ultimate key for wildlife photography is be patient. Wait for that special moment. Showcase it as your frame. This is all about our subject knowledge. Now, second, guys, you all are okay? Are you with me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay. So
I'm sure you don't want interruptions now.
Yeah. Yeah. This time it is definitely you will get chance to interrupt me because there are going to be a lot of controversies. So so that time all are welcome. So now the second thing in that always in this time you need to just think about the result triangle and three factors. So one factor I explain now about the subject knowledge. Now the second thing is skill set. So again, the skill set we can divide into two. Number one is the technical know-how, which is the craft skill. You know, the craft skill for taking a photo. And second thing is the creative eye. So what is that? Let us have a discussion. So here in technical know-how is the craft skill. You know, this is all coming, the science about photography, your knowledge about photography, exposure triangle, your all stepping lessons in your, throughout your journey to become a photographer. All these things are coming, we all start with our, exposure triangle. Then the functions and buttons of your camera. So how well versed you are with these buttons. Then the basic idea about focal length, depth of field, quality of light, all these things, it is your technical skill set. So this, you need to develop yourself a lot and you need to make strengthen it, this skill set. And of course the post-processing. So because when you present that photo, you need to have a lot of fine touches and fine tuning in your post-processing session. So this is it is your technical know-how. Now, creative eye is
something which you eventually develop as your own, you know, your own skill. Your own skill. It is more or less like your artistic skill. So this is how you know, your talent and your capability and ability to find a subject and its complementing elements in a frame. You know, when you look at a frame, so your subject may be there. That may be the reason why you wanted to take a photo. Yeah. But at the same time, with that frame, you may have different elements which can complement the subject. At the same time, there may be a lot of other distractions which you wanted to eliminate from the frame. You know, this is an artistic skill you need to eventually develop. So this is the composition, as broadly people say that this is all about that one. Just like, you know, subject, the positioning subject and separating it from the background and foreground and balancing the frame. All these things are coming under composition. Then the point of view. Point of view, each frame, each picture, each subject is going to be looks different. The perceptions is going to be different according to the point of view. You all know that. So this, in which point of view is going to be the best view to project, to, you know, emphasize this subject. So that is your creative eye. Second thing, making use of light to create beautiful frames. This is also your artistic skill, you know, like backlighting, rim lighting, and other lights, using lights to create different shades. All these things, you know, this is eventually you develop yourself. Especially like, you know, visualizing the subject, visualizing the image, and not the subject. I mean, visualizing the output of your click. I know that image, how it looks after the post-processing, how it should be. So you all need to visualize these things during your photo, taking the photo. So these two things, these two sections are having very fine difference, you know, very more. There are many cases it can overlap each other and it complement one to another. For example, like light. Judging a quality of light and the ISO setting according to the available light, probably your technical knowledge. But making use of the same light to a creative frame, that is coming into the second section, the artistic skill. So you understand that with the same topic, light has got two sections. So in the same way, you can have multiple factors with the which can contribute to the section one and the section two. So eventually, we all need to develop our own style and stamp in the field of photography. I mean, wildlife photography. I'm particularly talking about wildlife photography, but this is applicable to any photography. So eventually, our aim is to stand out our pictures from others. Yeah. So this is developing a skill set. So now we covered two portions of our triangle: the subject knowledge, and the second thing is skill set. Now the third thing is the quality of equipment. See, quality of equipment is, the quality of equipment is, again, a lot of controversies and debate can happen at this point. Because I have heard from many legendary photographers and the mentors that, you know, the best camera in the world is the camera what you have. The best lens in the world is the camera, the lens what you have. The photographer is taking photos, not the camera. So these all statements, which is good, which is one way, these all statements are good to promote you, to motivate you, to not underestimate your gears and all. But this is something you need to be realistic about these things. You know, actual thing is the quality of gears is really having a major role in output frame. You know, the result of a click. All other things are like marketing stunt. You can, as a motivation photographer, or, one way it is motivating you, then it is fine. It is absolutely fine, no problem. But at the same time, quality of gears is really important to take a good picture. What I mean to say is, like the people, all these legendary photographers, mentors, whoever giving these all preachers, none of them have seen shooting their wildlife photos with their Nikon D90 with 18-105 lens, kit lens. I never seen anybody. Even in the Canon ambassadors, there are so many guys. I have never seen anybody with a small camera because they also know that it is not going to get that result. So this is the fact. So the thing is, our point is, like what I wanted to tell you is, this is all according to our choice. The choice is maybe having different factors. The cost is one factor. Our priority has got factor. And you know, how much you want to spend. All these things, it is there. But at the end of the day, the quality of gears has got major role in giving you a result. That is what I mean to say. So the thing is, like whatever gears what you have, you need to understand the capabilities and at the same time the limitation of your camera and lenses. Accordingly, you need to shoot your photos. Never underestimate the true possibility of your gears. That is also an important thing. You know, most of the time we can see in field, you know, people with the big lenses, they are taking photos, and the small lenses, they have that, you know, some insecurity feelings or this, you know, this, my camera is not enough to take a photo. No need to think that way. But at the same time, there are two differences between these two. So at the end of the day, the bottom line is, like, to perform a wildlife, serious wildlife photography, you need to have at least 150 to 200 or 300 mm lens, quality lens for big subjects like mammals and animals. And at the same time, 400 mm and above is required for birds. So this is something which you require to have. So this is what about all result triangle. Like now we already discussed the subject knowledge, skill set, and quality of gears.
Sumesh, sorry to interrupt. I think we got just 2 minutes to end this session. So we have to restart in the session 2 link. Okay.
No problem.
Yeah.
No problem. This one, first portion is complete. So this is good that it.
Okay.
So you mean to say we should go out now?
Yeah. So use the second link. There is a session 2 link. Meeting ID and this one. Let me, Sumesh, can you stop sharing the screen?
Yeah, I can.
Okay, I think those who doesn't have, I just copied to the chat window. Okay, so I'm sending in the chat window. So I'll stop this one. Once it's disconnected, we can.
At the same time, this you know, my first portion is completed. So if anybody has got any quick discussion, it is required, then we can have it very immediately. The first at the start of second session.
Okay, and one more request: can you enable your cameras? I want to take a screenshot for the first session. It's my group photo session, I would say. Okay.
Is it wide angle?
Any angle, no problem. 1 second, let me open mine also. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay. Thank you. So we will disconnect like now.
This is like marking the attendance so that nobody skips the second session, right?
Yeah. Okay, so I will end this meeting now because it will discontinue now right now. So just join in the second session.
One more cute thing, Lipit.
Yeah.
The second session is also going to be 40 minutes or something?